Now, I've touched on the 49ers' inability to sign both Emmanuel Sanders and Arik Armstead, and I feel that everyone is split 50-50 on this. Some want Arik to be franchise tagged, others would like to see Sanders back to uplift this young receiving group. And another thing the 49ers can do to save money is to make roster cuts. And I hate speaking about other people's job security. Like, I don't want to be that guy on YouTube saying, oh, this guy should be cut, because we're dealing with people's livelihood here. But the truth is, the 49ers could be smart and make these moves if they want to have a chance to tag Armstead. Some common names that are being thrown out there are Jerick McKinnon and Marquise Goodwin. Now, Jerick McKinnon hasn't played a snap for the 49ers since signing back in 2018. He's prepared to make over $8 million this year. And the 49ers with Coleman and Mostert still on their roster, this makes total sense to me to just let him walk. Tevin Coleman is scheduled to make just under $5 million. Mostert is at around $3 million. That right there, you're at $8 million for two players. They can also re-sign Breida or Jeff Wilson Jr. since both of them are restricted free agents. So financially, this makes complete sense. You also have to wonder about the Jets' injury history. I mean, he hasn't been able to play football for 2 years now. So the Niners obviously have cheaper running back options out there. And I think they'll flex that move and make it happen. It just makes sense. Marquise Goodwin seems like another obvious choice to let him go this year. And just from a roster standpoint, Goodwin would have to compete with Debo, Dante Pettis, Jalen Hurd, and Trent Taylor. And I'm picking all four of those guys ahead of him. Also, I'm assuming that the 49ers will re-sign Kendrick Bourne since he's also a restricted free agent this year. I think they do get that deal done. I hope they do. I love Bourne. Kendrick Bourne has really grown on me. Loved him since last year. And I feel like he has a lot of potential left. He took big strides this year. You also have to think that the 49ers may be considering drafting another wide receiver in this year's draft. So that makes it more difficult for me to keep Goodwin. And I personally would like Sanders back as well. So all directions are pointing to the 49ers moving on from Goodwin. You also have to think that the 49ers will have to pick up Kyle Juszczyk's club option this year. This is going to be a pricey move. It's going to cost close to $7 million for this year alone. I mean, you have a lot of moving pieces that need to happen before we even start considering Arik or Emmanuel Sanders, because like I said, the Niners are going to have to hold on to a lot of their own players. They're not going to be able to hold on to everyone. So you basically have to go with positions that are in need. And right now, running back and wide receiver are areas where we can definitely make some cuts. And those two are just obvious choices, in my opinion. But, you know, let me hear from you. What other players could possibly be gone due to their current contract situation? I think I pointed out the obvious, but go ahead and drop your comment below. Niners have quite a few restricted free agents this year. The big names are, of course, is the unrestricted free agent players like Jimmy Ward, Sanders, Armstead. You have Ben Garland, Ronald Blair, Sheldon Day. Those are the big names there. And so, yeah, there's going to be good players walking away this year. We also have to focus on the draft, which I'll do in later videos. But yeah, you know, something to think about as we're approaching March. And so I love to hear your thoughts. Like I said, last video's comment section in my eyes was like 50-50. People wanted Sanders, people wanted Arik Armstead. So there's a lot of talk on those players there. But anyways, guys, appreciate you guys watching. Thank you for your comments, and we'll see you on the next one. Peace.